this is nice, isn't it? Nice leisurely stroll with a pretty lady on my arm.
Just glad I let you out of our run this morning.
Yes, I am very glad. But mostly glad to be with you.
You're such a charmer.
You know, we have a very special date coming up.
Do we?
Well,
I know, it's the anniversary of our first date.
That was not nice.
I'm sorry, you're just very cute when you're befuddled.
Okay, I accept that apology. So as I was saying, why don't we do something special?
I like the sound of that.
Right? Hey, isn't that
Clayton Morrell, the murderer who was just granted parole 4 months ago. He's out with his own autobiography.
People love to read about true crime, and his release was big news.
There's a real fascination with the psychology of murder, but I know a lot of people who are going to be triggered by this.
Are you all right? I know you were second chair in his murder trial. This can't be easy for you.
I'm fine, but Paulina, on the other hand, is not coping, and the district attorney cannot afford to be distracted by this.
And the media has not been nice to her. It's true. I have to get to the office. Do you want a ride?
I'll walk from here. Bye.
Thanks.
Haley Dean.
Mr. Morrell.
I haven't seen you since I got out. Don't worry, I didn't take personally any of that stuff you said about me at the parole hearing.
Well, I meant every word. You still belong behind bars.
The state of Georgia doesn't agree with you, it seems. You coming to my book signing tonight?
That's too bad. I mean you in the book, after all. Don't worry, I didn't say anything bad about you. I can't say the same for your friend, Paulina.
I doubt you're on a first-name basis with the district attorney.
She and I are like two sides of the same coin. She's a lot more like me than she wants to admit.
I doubt she'd see it that way.
If you see her, you should bring her along tonight. Her fans will be thrilled to watch the sparks fly. It was really good to see you. Take care of yourself.
I don't know, Fincher. He doesn't scare me, but when I saw him, I got the feeling that something was gonna happen.
What kind of something?
I'm not sure, but nothing good.
Well, your instincts are on the money, but you can't stop Clayton Morrell from doing whatever he's gonna do.
I know.
Man, he's on parole. He has to report in regularly, and he's subject to surprise visits, and he has a neighbor that watches his every move.
Walter Faraday, you're right. It's all so unsettling.
Yeah, I agree. You talked to Paulina?
Yeah. I called her, but she was in a meeting. I think I'm gonna stop by the office after this.
It's a good idea. She could use a friend.
A friend like you?
Yep, best kind of friend.
And what kind is that?
The kind of friend that helps you eat the food that you're not eating very quickly.
Hey, this is my food. Don't you eat it?
Okay. Let me ask you some advice.
Always.
Say I was gonna buy Megan a present, like a ring.
You're gonna buy Megan a ring?
As an example.
No, no. A ring isn't an example. Are you asking Megan to marry you?
Oh. Whoa.
Fincher, you see why I'm asking? You don't just buy a woman a ring.
I know, it's like any other piece of jewelry.
No, it's not. A woman sees a ring box, and she automatically assumes that's a proposal.
Okay, how about a bracelet, then?
Okay, so what's the occasion?
Is it her birthday?
Well, when is it? I want to get her something, too.
I said birthday. I meant because day. Just because.
Oh, right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because day.
You know what? Got some work stuff to get to. You know, we can talk later. What you think?
Venture, where are you going? I drove.
Yes, you did. This whole work thing got me preoccupied.
This is real good, man. Thanks, Matt.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, we are fully engaged on the Gratham case, and I promise the missing recording will be located by the end of the day. Thank you.
Is this a bad time?
Oh, Haley, not at all. You remember Alex Mathers?
Of course. Hi, Alex.
Feels like only yesterday we were newbies together.
And look at you now, second in command to the DA, right on schedule, if I remember.
Alex, if you could get on that problem we were discussing.
Of course.
Thank you.
It's nice to see you, Haley.
You too. Seems a bit stressful around here.
I don't know what's happening. I always run such a tight ship. But all of a sudden, there's all these missing files, missing meetings. Things have gone haywire. I don't know what's going on.
Think you're a bit distracted?
Distracted by what?
I assume you know about Clayton Morrell's book.
I was sent an advance copy, if you can believe it, along with an invitation to the local book signing.
So have you read it?
Absolutely not.
Well, I know I've been a bit thrown by the whole thing, so I can only imagine how you must be feeling.
Haley, I know your intentions are good, but I don't need a therapist. What I need is to get my office in order and Clayton Morrell out of my head.
All right, well, you let me know if you need any help talking things through.
You know I will.
Not only does convicted murderer, wife killer Clayton Morrell get parole after just one parole hearing, which I have never seen in the history of paroles, Morrell is now practically parading with a new book. Yes, you heard me, a new book. Details his life, including the murder of his wife, Tamara. And that's what I call blood money.
Hey, someone wanted to say hello.
Amelia, hi. Nice to see you again. I'm so glad you kept up your work with Sabrina. I know how difficult these last few months have been for you.
Honestly, I don't know what I would have done without Sabrina.
We're always here for you.
Thank you. The book that Clayton wrote about my sister's murder is affecting me more than I thought.
Well, understandably. There's something else, isn't there?
I saw the poster for the book. In the background is a vase my parents gave to my sister on her wedding day to Clayton.
That must have been a shock.
He moved back into the house where he killed my sister, and now I find out he still has Tamara's things? I mean, I admit, I kind of lost it.
What happened?
I went to the house. The spare key was in the same place Tamara kept it, behind the mailbox. I walk up to the house, but something stops me. I can almost see my sister sitting on the porch, just warning me not to go in. I turned to leave, and just then, Clayton drove up. I asked him for the vase. He refused. He said he was going to file a restraining order and that I'd been stalking the house ever since he got out.
Had you?
No, I hadn't been back in 10 years. If I hadn't seen the poster, I wouldn't have remembered the vase. It's a family heirloom. It means nothing to him, but everything to me. I should have known better. I'm a teacher. If this complaint sticks, I could lose my job.
I know some people at Atlanta PD. I'll see what I can find out.
But why do I get the feeling this is not a social call?
I don't suppose you could tell me if someone's filed a restraining order.
What's the name?
Clayton Morrell.
Is he harassing someone? Because I'll have to report that to his parole officer.
He claims he's the one being harassed.
Well, let's see if he's filed anything. Yes, actually, he filed a complaint against Amelia Lincoln.
Isn't that his ex-sister-in-law?
Yes. What can we do about it?
Well, you know how this goes. Only the complainant can rescind the complaint.
I know, I was just hoping for any other alternative. Thanks for coming with me. I'm dreading this, but I would rather talk to Clayton Morrell about dropping the complaint against Amelia in a public setting.
Well, you know I wasn't gonna let you come alone.
Where is everybody? I thought this would be a big draw.
Yeah, me too, even if it was a morbid curiosity.
Excuse me, is the book signing canceled?
Yes, unfortunately. I'm afraid the author isn't able to make it. But would you like a copy? It is very well written. Humanizes the whole thing.
No, thanks. I'm very familiar with the story.
Aren't you Haley Dean, right? You were part of the prosecution at Clayton's trial.
Yes, that's right.
I'm Frank Burlett. I was there. I've known Clayton since university.
Since college?
Right. I'm from up north. Came down for second year and just stayed.
You mean sophomore year?
Right, yes. I can't ever seem to adapt to talking about it like that.
Interesting how you're still friends with Clayton Morrell.
I know it doesn't make me popular, but I always believed Clayton when he told me it was an accident that he shot Tamara because he thought she was an intruder. He's my friend. Friends stand by one another.
Well, he's lucky to have you in his life.
I'm not sure he feels the same way, or he wouldn't have blown off this book signing.
Did he give you a reason?
I can't reach him on his phone. It's not surprising. Haley Dean, what are you doing here?
Derek Robinson, do you still represent Clayton Morrell?
Not that it's any of your business, but yes.
Why does he need an attorney?
Because of people like you who refuse to let him live in peace. Clayton served his time. He was released. He has rights like everyone else, including the right to privacy.
I'd rather not talk to him on his home turf, but there doesn't appear to be a choice.
You really think you can get Clayton Morrell to listen to reason?
No, but I owe it to Amelia to try. She's been through enough already.
You think she was the one watching the house?
I believed her when she denied it. There's a car in the driveway.
Well, maybe he and his wife have two cars and they went somewhere together.
Somewhere other than the book signing?
Maybe he blew it off. Doesn't strike me as the kind of guy that keeps his word.
True. But Clayton Morrell is a narcissist. I can't believe he would miss the opportunity to soak up all this public attention. Something's not right.
Uh-oh. Clayton Morrell. He looks dead.
Yeah, we knocked on the door. When no one answered, I looked in the window and saw the body.
And that's when we called 911.
And you were here to talk to the victim about a restraining order.
I'm going to be here most of the night, so can you both come down to the station and make an official statement first thing tomorrow?
Of course. Have you talked to Walter Faraday?
Who's he?
He's the neighbor across the street. He is a one-man neighborhood watch.
I've got officers canvassing. Why is he of interest?
He was the witness in the Clayton Morrell trial 10 years ago, but he never took the stand.
Paulina was concerned that his testimony could backfire. He had a history of alcohol abuse. And he could have been discredited.
And you think Mr. Faraday might have been motivated to take the law into his own hands?
I don't know that Walter's a killer, but he stopped drinking after the trial, and if anyone saw anything, he did.
Well, I think that everyone knew something might happen with Clayton Morrell getting out of prison after only 10 years. But I don't think that anyone thought he'd be the one to end up dead.
I certainly didn't.
This is going to be big news. The chief has already called the mayor, and they want this solved as quickly as possible.
You found anything yet?
No. No murder weapon so far, no sign of a break-in.
So someone he knew?
Or someone he let in.
I haven't been able to reach his wife, Naomi. Forensics is doing a full sweep. So far, all we have is a partial shoe print that was found by the body.
It's strange that the killer would leave a shoe print behind and nothing else.
Well, it's pretty clearly a homicide. Looks like he was stabbed several times. I'll be able to get a better idea of the exact weapon once I've done the autopsy.
The district attorney just pulled up.
Oh, okay.
Is it true? Is he dead?
Yes.
Murdered?
Yes.
Where is he?
Are you here as the district attorney?
What else would I be here as?
Someone with unresolved feelings for the victim?
I don't care for your tone, Haley.
Paulina, everyone knows your history with Clayton Morrell. You've been very distracted at the office, and some people might see him and his new book as the reason why. This might be one crime scene you shouldn't be at.
I'll make sure she gets him okay.
Thanks, Finch.
Cross every T, dot every I.
I hear you.
It's important.
Gotcha. Don't worry.
Okay, I think that'll do it. Thanks to you both.
Any leads?
No witnesses so far. That neighbor you mentioned, Walter Faraday, he hasn't been home. I've got regular patrols on the street, and forensics is still in the house, so we'll catch him when he gets back.
What about the wife, Naomi Morrell?
I haven't spoken to her yet. Apparently, she was out of town and is on her way back now.
Hey, Monty.
Jonas, good timing. Tell me that you have something.
Time of death was last night around 8 p.m., give or take an hour on either side. He was stabbed with what is probably an ordinary kitchen knife.
Crime of opportunity.
Maybe. There were 6 stab wounds. The first one was to the heart and would have killed him almost immediately. The subsequent 5 wounds were inflicted post-mortem.
Wow. That implies both planning and rage.
Revenge killing?
Quite possibly.
Monty, what about that partial shoe print you mentioned?
They're running it now. As of this moment, it is the key piece of evidence that we need to tie someone other than the wife to the scene of the crime.
You must have a long list of suspects.
Too long. Haley, what's your insight given your history with the victim?
I mean, I think the early release of Clayton Morrell took a lot of people by surprise.
Now, what about Amelia Lincoln? She admitted to having an altercation with the victim, and he was convinced that she was stalking him.
I can't deny the motive. She was understandably upset that her sister's killer was paroled, but I don't see her as a killer.
Maybe the complaint against her was the last straw.
Detective Montgomery. Thank you. Naomi Morrell is on her way in.
I get 10 messages from you people saying nothing. I get home to find my house swarming with cops. I can't even go inside. And all anyone will say is, you have to talk to Detective Montgomery. So, Detective,
here I am, against my better judgment. What is going on?
Mrs. Morrell, I am sorry for the secrecy. But I wanted to speak to you in person about your husband.
Whatever it is, Clayton didn't do it. I'll go straight to the press if you don't let him go.
I'm afraid that's not the issue. I'm so sorry to tell you, but your husband has passed away.
He's dead? How?
We believe he was killed.
Murdered? Well,
do you know anyone who might have been angry with him?
Yes. The establishment, for one. The police, the district attorney, you name it.
When was the last time you spoke to your husband?
I don't know. A couple of days?
I was at a friend's house in Macon.
How long were you gone?
I was at a friend's house in Macon.
How long were you gone?
Are you asking me for an alibi?
We just want to be sure that we have all the facts.
I left on Thursday and came back today.
Did your husband mention any plans that he had while you were gone? Visitors to the house? Meetings?
No. If you want to know who did this, look a little closer to your own house than mine.
I can't put my finger on it, but Naomi Morrell definitely wasn't being completely honest.
You think she knows who the killer is?
I don't know. Maybe, but I didn't even get the sense that she was upset.
You always say people grieve in different ways.
This was more calculating. Like, instead of grieving, she was planning.
That's ominous. But then again, who would marry a man convicted of killing his first wife?
Maybe she's just like her husband. Lacking empathy could explain her non-reaction to the news of her husband's death.
Well, that's scary. You think maybe she killed him?
Well, Monty talked to her friend in Macon who corroborated her alibi.
Yeah, but you don't buy it.
Facts are facts. All I have is a feeling that she's not being completely honest.
Looks like Monty's right. This case is big news.
The press is just gonna complicate things.
I don't know. They're all over the place.
Derek.
Haley.
Join the good guys?
I know better than to jump from one sinking ship to the next.
How are you holding up?
Holding up? Oh, Clayton, he was a client, now he's no longer a client. But I don't want to pretend we were friends, but he didn't deserve to die.
Some would argue neither did his first wife.
He did his time. He deserved a second chance.
Well, I'm sorry for your loss.
No, you aren't. And if I were you, I'd be very careful who I'm seen with in the coming days.
Mm-hmm. What is that supposed to mean?
Sound like a threat.
I was thinking the same thing. I'm gonna go check on Paulina.
All right. You know where I'll be when you're done.
If you're here to see Paulina, she's really busy today.
Oh, I bet. I'll just pop in and say hello.
Well, please make it quick. We really need to get this office under control. And now that Clayton Morrell is no longer such a distraction, maybe things will get back to normal around here.
You know, Alex, whatever we thought about Clayton Morrell, he's the victim now. And this office is going to have to prosecute his killer.
Of course. In the meantime, we have other cases that need our attention.
I swear I had this month's case files organized, and now I can't find them anywhere.
Maybe you should consider taking a few days off.
Impossible.
Paulina, I think you need to deal with what's just happened.
What is there to deal with? He's dead. It's over.
Paulina.
What is it that you want to hear, Haley? That I'm glad that he died? Part of me is. Well, relieved is a better word. And a bit sorry that my mistake at trial is only fixed because he died.
Why don't we go somewhere and talk about this?
Haley. I appreciate your concern, and you know that I love you, but I don't have time to talk about something that's already over and done with.
If you change your mind.
I won't.
I don't know, Fincher. I just really worry about Paulina.
Yeah, she hasn't been the same since Clayton Morrell was released. Maybe now she can really move on.
I hope so.
What's this all about?
I'm Naomi Morrell, wife of Clayton Morrell. My husband was brutally murdered in our home yesterday, and I'm here to tell you, I know who killed him.
She's going to publicly name Amelia. This has to be about the complaint. This is going to ruin Amelia's life. Can we stop it?
I don't think so.
The person who killed my husband is the district attorney of Atlanta, Paulina Durazio.
My news alerts are full of Naomi's statement. It's the only thing anybody's talking about.
Monty said her phone has been ringing off the hook. This isn't going to make solving this case any easier.
Why didn't Naomi go to the press?
She doesn't trust the police. She must not realize the consequences of going public with an unsubstantiated claim like that.
Unless she does.
Mrs. Morrell, I understand how you must be feeling. You mean that I went away for a few days and came back to find my husband murdered, and the cops oblivious to the most obvious suspect.
I assure you, we are doing everything that we can to bring his killer to justice.
I told you to look inside your own house. You didn't take me seriously.
It's been less than 48 hours. These investigations need time, and they need confidentiality, and I have to ask you for your patience.
While you conspire to cover it up, you mean?
I hope you understand how damaging your comments will be to this investigation.
Because you honestly would have investigated the district attorney if I didn't say anything publicly.
If that's where the evidence leads, then yes.
Forgive me if I don't believe you.
Can you tell me why you think Ms. Durazio killed your husband?
Because Clayton said that she would.
Why did he say that?
Because Clayton said that she would.
Why did he say that?
Because he knew something, obviously. Clayton said if anything were to ever happen to him, look first at Paulina, and the proof would be in his book.
Did Paulina threaten Clayton?
Not that I ever saw, and even if she did, it's hardly proof of murder, especially coming from someone like Paulina.
Fincher, you work with her. Is it possible?
No. I mean, she hasn't been herself since Clayton Morrell got out of jail, but who would be?
I called the publisher. Mr. Morrell wrote this book while he was incarcerated, which can only mean that whatever proof he put in here existed before he got out.
It would have to be from 10 years ago. I was at that trial, and the contact between them was never one-on-one.
Did Paulina visit him in prison?
Not that I know of.
They've asked me to take some time off from work. Can you believe it?
I can, actually.
Well, I will be there tomorrow. I have a civic duty, and I'm not going to let some slanderous nonsense keep me from doing it.
Good.
You know, I think you're the only one sticking by me. It's amazing how a whiff of scandal and supposed friends just go running.
Do you know what Naomi was talking about?
No. I never read that trash he published. I'm sure he just painted me as the bad guy to make himself look more sympathetic.
And there's nothing else?
Not at all.
All right. Did you find anything in the book?
No. I put a call into the publisher to see if anything was left out. If it was libelous, it might have been cut.
Let me guess, they referred you to their legal team.
Of course. And they weren't much help.
I might have a way of finding out. Selling like hotcakes?
Barely keep it stocked. Would you like a copy this time?
No, I came to talk to you.
Oh, how can I help?
Naomi is under the impression that her husband names his murderer in there.
Oh, you're talking about the district attorney visiting Clayton in prison?
She visited him?
Right before his parole hearing. Apparently, Ms. D'Orazio told Clayton that if he got parole, she'd see to it that he wished he was still safe on the inside.
Are you sure?
That's what Clayton told me. And the publisher wasn't going to put it in the book. They said it was libel and they didn't want to get sued.
They were right.
Now it's hearsay. Clayton knew who wanted to kill him. He was trying to protect himself. But the law was never on his side, was it?
I verified with the prison that you did indeed visit Clayton Morrell the day before his parole hearing.
Yes.
What did you say to him?
I told him the world didn't want him back. I didn't threaten him. I just told him the truth.
You shouldn't have gone alone. I would have gone with you.
It was something I wanted to do on my own.
But now there's no witness to what was said. And the publisher has Clayton Morrell's original first draft where he describes your visit to the prison and the direct threat you made against his life.
Which is now in evidence.
It's hearsay. It'll never stand up in court.
But if the press gets wind of it?
Well, luckily, I'm not being tried by the court of public opinion. And I assume, Detective, you're still following the evidence and pursuing legitimate suspects?
Of course.
Well, if you don't mind.
Paulina's right. I can't waste more time following up on Naomi's grudges. I'm on my way to talk to Amelia Lincoln.
I know she's the most likely suspect, but I really hope it isn't her.
She's been avoiding my calls. She's lucky I've been preoccupied with Naomi's accusations. The chat with Amelia is overdue.
Yeah. There you go. Pass it.
Go.
Got it. Defense, perfect. Take a shot. Oh. Hit the showers, you guys. Okay. Amelia, this is Detective Montgomery. You've been avoiding her calls.
I have nothing to say about Clayton Morrell.
You know Mr. Morrell filed a complaint against you. He claimed that you were watching his house. He also claimed that you assaulted him over property that was legally his.
I didn't assault him. I may have pushed him. He wouldn't listen to me. I wanted my sister's vase.
Where were you Friday night between 7 and 9 p.m.?
Here. It was parent-teacher night. I had several conferences.
What do you teach?
Gym and remedial math. I tend to have longer conferences for my remedial students. The principal can confirm it.
So, if you have an alibi, why were you avoiding her calls?
I am tired of talking about Clayton. Tired of him haunting my dreams. He's finally dead, Haley. I just want to move on.
Gotta move on, guys. Let's go.
Yep.
Oh, good morning.
Hey.
This is a surprise.
You forgot.
Forgot what?
Today's the anniversary of our first date.
What, today?
Yes, today. Remember retirement dinner at Chesley's?
Oh, no, Jonas, I didn't realize what you meant.
Oh, what did you think I meant?
To me, that wasn't our first date. That was just the first time we met.
And then we had a quiet drink together. You told me all about you. I told you all about me.
I didn't consider that our first date, but I guess I can see why you would. So let me try to clear my schedule. Oh, it's Fincher. Hey, Fincher on speaker.
Guess who just got home? Walter Faraday. If anyone can help us get Paulina out of the spotlight, it'll be him.
I'll call you from the car.
It's fine. Go do what you need to do. We can have our anniversary on our other first date.
Thank you. Here.
Oh no, I interrupted your anniversary date?
Not really. Jonas and I have a different idea of when our first date actually was.
How could you not know when your first date was?
Okay, so was your first date with Megan speed dating or food truck?
That's easy. Speed date. It was a date.
Was it really? I mean, yes, you met there, but you hadn't intended to spend time together.
Okay, I see your point. Well, then food truck. But by that rationale, I didn't agree to meet Megan. You know, she tracked me down in ambush because I'm so cute.
Right, but you could make the case that the next time you decided to get together, that was your first official date.
This is all much more complicated than I thought.
Dating is very complicated.
Maybe you're overthinking it.
Highly likely.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Faraday, this is Fincher Garland from the DA's office, and I'm Haley Dean.
I remember you from Clayton's trial 10 years ago. I never blamed Mr. Razzio, but I saw him breaking his own window, trying to make it look like he was shooting an intruder and not his wife.
I know you did.
He should have gone away for life, not 10 measly years.
Yeah, we were hoping that maybe you saw something.
I just got back. I left Friday morning. I've never won anything in my life until last week when I won a free fishing trip. They gave me this souvenir sign.
Kind of nice, don't you think? Has anyone come to visit Mr. Morrell since he's been out of prison?
Sure. And I've written it all down.
You kept a record?
I couldn't let what happened last time happen again.
Can we see it?
I don't know if any of it means anything.
Did you notice anyone watching the Morrell house?
Almost every day since he got out of prison. The same person.
Can you describe this person?
Better than that, I have photos.
Can we see him?
Walter Faraday, you've been stalking Clayton Morrell.
Not stalking, watching, waiting for him to make the smallest mistake so I could throw him back in jail.
The onus isn't on you.
You might not think it was, but I know it was.
Paulina, I knew you were struggling with this, but I didn't know how much.
I wasn't at Clayton Morrell's house the night he died. An anonymous source said they had information that would put Clayton Morrell back in jail asked to meet me in a parking lot. I was there from 7:30 till almost 9 o'clock.
Who was the source?
I don't know. They never showed.
Man or woman?
I don't know that either. They put a note under my door.
Do you still have it?
Are you interrogating me?
No, I'm sorry. I'm just trying to find out what happened so I can help.
Did you already tell the police this?
I stopped here on my way.
Then you need to give me a ride there because they need to hear this straight from me.
Okay.
This is just getting worse and worse for Paulina.
I know. What about her alibi?
We recovered the note from her house. Typed and printed off a standard laser printer.
Fingerprints?
Only Paulina's. The GPS on her car and her phone verify that she was in that parking lot. At least her car and her phone were in that parking lot.
What are you saying?
It's a 5-minute walk through a park to Clayton Morrell Street. There are no cameras, no way to verify that she didn't leave her car.
No way to verify that she did.
It's a shaky alibi, Haley. Paulina could have easily typed that note herself. We may have to consider the possibility that Paulina had a hand in Clayton Morrell's death.
I know the cop in you is saying that, but it isn't true.
I won't be able to keep the evidence against Paulina quiet for very long.
Well, we can't give up. I know she's innocent.
An innocent person doesn't need to lie, Haley. She should have been straight with us from the beginning. I'll keep you both posted.
Oh, this is breaking my heart. It has to be a misunderstanding.
I know it looks bad, Haley, but it's all just circumstantial. Maybe Walter Faraday saw someone else, too.
That's true. Isn't it strange that he went on a fishing trip right before Clayton Moreau was murdered in his own home?
Timing's just a little too perfect.
And if somebody knew that Walter had the habit of spying on the Morell house, they'd want him out of the way.
He did say he won that trip. Let me look into it and see what I can find.
I'm sorry I snapped at you. I know that you were just trying to help.
It's forgotten.
I have been in such a state. I don't think I realized how serious my actions have been. I mean, what was I thinking watching him like that?
You weren't thinking, but you also didn't expect Clayton Moreau would end up a victim.
Haley, can I confess something to you?
Only if you want to.
I don't think the mayor's gonna stick by me. I've already been sidelined. No public appearances, no court. I'm not allowed to speak to the press on my behalf or the behalf of the DA's office. If even a whiff of this gets out, I'm afraid I'm done for.
I'll do everything I can to keep that from happening.
That means the world to me.
Are you gonna be okay?
I think so. Thank you.
Hey, Monty.
Hey, how's Paulina?
Shaken, but resolved.
Hey, been going through Walter Faraday's journal. He pretty much listed every coming and going from the Morell house from the moment they moved back in.
Anything of interest?
One thing, maybe. He wrote down a big fight between Naomi and Clayton the day before he died.
The day Naomi left for a friend's house?
Yeah, it must have been before Walter left for his fishing trip.
Wow. These pictures show a very different dynamic than I would have expected.
What do you mean?
Well, look at the body language. She's leaning in, intimidating him.
Yeah, I see. Clayton is shrinking away. Submissive.
She was definitely the aggressor in this fight. I wonder if she was the aggressor in the relationship.
Yeah, but Naomi was in Macon.
Or she was gone, then came back, then was gone again. It's only an hour and a half on a bad day. Let me call Macon police and see if they can get a more detailed itinerary out of Naomi's friend. Get me Macon police.
I didn't think you had any clients today. I just had to get my mind off the whole Clayton Moreau thing. You want to talk? I don't know, Sabrina. How do I know when I'm listening to my bias instead of the truth?
You don't. But instincts have a way of circumventing emotions. So you can frame them any way you want to, but until you resolve the truth of what your instincts are telling you, they won't leave you alone.
I know it's true. I just worry that I've been fooled by friendship before.
All the more reason why it wouldn't happen again.
What are you doing here?
Consulting.
Hope you're not trying to influence the investigation.
I'm just here to observe and consult when asked. I don't bend the law to suit anyone.
What was that all about?
Old wounds run deep, I expect.
Wasn't that Clayton Morell's lawyer?
And lost a trial to Paulina, yep.
Well, then I suppose he'll be here to represent Naomi.
My guess is he won't let her say a word.
Can you verify your whereabouts the night that Clayton Moreau was killed?
My client has already given you that information.
We have since received a witness statement claiming that he saw Mrs. Moreau enter her house the day that her husband died.
Which witness is more credible? A friend with no ties to my client's husband?
Or the drunk from across the street with a chip on his shoulder?
Mrs. Moreau's friend in Macon has been questioned by the local police and is unable to account for Mrs. Moreau's whereabouts between noon and 10 p.m. the night her husband was killed.
My client has nothing to say at this time.
Was your marriage happy?
Don't answer that.
We have evidence that you and your husband argued in the days leading up to his death. Can you tell me what about?
Don't answer that either. This is
a fishing expedition, and unless you have hard evidence linking my client to the death of her husband, she has nothing more to tell you.
Are you sure that your client doesn't want to explain why she lied about her alibi? What were you doing between noon and 10 p.m.?
You already know who's guilty. This is all a waste of everyone's time.
No, not everyone's. And you get paid by the hour, after all.
We're done here.
And
turn out the way I'd hoped.
No, the only time she wanted to say something was about her friend blowing her alibi, and then her reaction was more annoyed than anything else.
Clayton Morrell didn't have any real assets. He owned the house and the contents, and he had some money, but nothing that Naomi didn't already have access to.
Whatever the reason she came back to the house that day is what she doesn't want us to know.
And as it stands, we may never find out. I'll get a warrant for the phone and the car GPS.
Derek won't give you access without one.
Well, that's the lab bag with the analysis of the shoe print found at the scene. It's from a unisex sneaker, but there was too little of it to determine a size.
Maybe Naomi's.
Well, there's no shoe like it at the house or anywhere nearby. I'll see if I can get a warrant for Naomi's car.
You know, this could take Paulina off the table. I've never seen her wear a sneaker in my life.
Well, if she'll submit to a voluntary search, it would go a long way in clearing her name.
I bet she would.
What you doing here?
Oh, I just stopped by to see Paulina on my way to the office, and you know I never turn down a free coffee.
Mm-hmm. I know that. Hey, while I have you here, if I want to do something special with Megan, you know, like for a date, should I wear like regular clothes or a suit?
You would voluntarily wear a suit?
It's been known to happen. So what's your preference?
Well, I don't think my preference is really what you're looking for, but I would say that you should probably dress at the same level as Megan. Does that help?
Maybe.
What is this special date? I'm dying of curiosity.
You don't need to know everything about my life.
No, you don't need to tell me everything, but somehow you always do.
Maybe I should stop telling you everything.
Well, that's just me.
Oh, no.
Paulina, it's gonna be fine. Don't say anything. I thought this was over.
I thought so too. But then we found this.
Is that?
Murder weapon. It was in Paulina's car.
No DNA evidence other than the blood, and no fingerprints found on the hilt of the knife that you found in Paulina's car. But the blood is a match to Clayton Morrell, and the knife is a match to the wounds that killed him.
I don't know what to say, Haley.
Monty, you can't believe all this.
It's not about what I believe. It's about the evidence.
Why would Paulina submit to a search if she knew the knife was in her car? She would have moved it.
That's one of the questions that I'm going to ask her.
Look, somebody planted it there. They're trying to frame Paulina.
I'm not ruling that out, but I can't rule out Paulina either.
Has she been charged?
Not yet.
Haley.
Paulina, listen to me. Say nothing.
I have nothing to hide. Alex, thank goodness you can get me out of here.
Haley, you can't be here. You're a civilian.
I'm consulting on this case.
Well, in that case, you should stay to hear this.
Hear what?
Out of courtesy for your position, that the DA's office will be pursuing a charge against you of murder in the first degree.
This is a nightmare. My job is stripped, my reputation is ruined, no one believes me.
I believe you, and if you want, I will happily represent you.
I don't want to drag you down with me.
Then I will find you the best defense attorney in Atlanta.
I don't think it will matter. I don't think there's any coming back from this, Haley.
Can you think of anyone who would want to frame you for murder?
I've been a prosecutor a long time. You know we make enemies. Someone's out to get me, Haley. I know how bad this is.
I'm going to get you out of this. I'm not surprised Alex was named acting DA, but I am surprised he turned on Paulina so quickly.
Thanks. Well, it's no secret that he planned to run for DA in the next election.
I knew he was ambitious, but I never pegged him as ruthless, and he was always loyal to Paulina.
I'd say he's only loyal to himself.
But would he kill Clayton Morrell just to frame Paulina?
That's a bit far-fetched. I mean, there's easier ways to discredit her.
Maybe he's just an opportunist.
How so?
Remember that Derek was at the DA's office the day of the murder?
You're thinking that Derek gave Alex a murder weapon to plant Paulina's car? So then you're saying that Derek killed Clayton Morrell? And why frame Paulina?
I don't know. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking somebody wanted Clayton Morrell gone, and Paulina was the best scapegoat.
Amelia Lincoln?
In one fell swoop, she would avenge her sister's murder and frame the person that she blamed for his early release.
But she has an alibi for the night of the murder.
True. What about the wife, Naomi? No alibi, potential motive?
No clear evidence of the actual crime, though her DNA is all over the house because she lived there. There's a whole lot of suspects, but nobody actually fits the crime.
No one except Paulina.
No. I know how it looks, but no.
You know what? Maybe you were onto something earlier.
Derek does not come off very well in this book. If I were him, I wouldn't want to be anywhere near Clayton Morrell.
It's strange, isn't it? So was his reaction, come to think of it.
Reaction to what?
Monty made a comment about him being paid by the hour, and his reaction made me think that she had hit a sore spot.
Well, his career did take a hit after losing the trial. Let me dig into him and see what I can find. Listen to this. I met Tamara my first year in university. She glowed with a lightness of spirit that felt like a balm to my darkness. I don't know Clayton Morrell very well, but does that sound like him?
No, it doesn't.
Maybe somebody else wrote this.
Met Tamara first year of university, not freshman year of college. I think it was written by someone else, and I think I know who.
You could tell it wasn't Clayton?
It just isn't his voice. It's a bit too cerebral. Did you write the book?
I'm not supposed to say.
Is it contractual?
A ghostwriter doesn't always have to keep it quiet.
And in your case, the publisher wanted to sell the myth of Clayton Morrell intellectual. I won't ask you anything you can't answer. Do ghostwriters make royalties?
Ghostwriters get a flat fee, no other percentage. So there is no benefit in staging a stunt to sell more books, if that's what you're asking.
Was it that obvious?
It's all right. I understand. I know you're friends with the district attorney and you believe her when she says she's innocent.
Just like you believed your friend.
I could not believe him. Tamara was my friend as well. She, Clayton, and I spent a lot of time together. And whatever people think about him, I knew him better. I do miss him. I miss them both.
I'm sorry for your loss.
That's kind of you to say.
How's Amelia doing? I've been meaning to check in with her.
She canceled her treatment.
Don't you mean she canceled her appointment?
No, her whole treatment. She said her problems are over. I tried to get her to come in anyway, but she refused.
Well, that's worrisome.
I agree. I don't want to push her, but I feel like the death of Clayton Morrell isn't something that she's equipped to handle on her own.
Maybe I'll stop by her school on my way home.
Thanks, Haley.
Up, you guys. All right, doing great, guys. Yep, go for it. Okay. Haley, what are you doing here?
I came to say hi. It's been a crazy couple of days. And Sabrina told me that you canceled your appointment with her.
Oh, it's nothing personal. I like Sabrina. I just don't need her anymore.
You sound so certain.
He's dead, Haley. And I realized my anger died with him.
Well, I can't speak for your feelings, but my guess is they're a little more complicated than that.
No, they aren't. I'm cured.
Well, that's great. Although I think Sabrina would sleep better at night if she could see that for herself.
She's worried about me?
I've been going through a lot. She'd want to make sure you're okay.
I didn't realize. I'll drop by.
Okay. I will set up an appointment for you just to make sure that she's available.
All right. Thanks, Haley. Way to catch it. Okay, pick it up. Let's do it. There we go.
Hello, beautiful.
Where are you?
I'm at work. Why? Where are you?
I'm at the restaurant for our anniversary.
That's not tonight.
Not again.
After the first time we met, the first date ended with our first kiss at Chesley's. Why, what did you think our first date was?
Philly cheesesteaks, remember?
Oh, sure, but you were really giving off a friend's vibe.
What, because I didn't kiss you? I didn't realize a date had to be defined by a kiss.
No. And that kiss was the first time I knew you were interested in me. Before then, I was only desperately hoping.
I was interested in you long before that, but I can accept that. I guess it's the first moment I realized you were interested in me, too.
Well, you want to wait? I can try to finish up here and get over to you.
No, I want to do this properly. So the anniversary of our first date, our first kiss, and the beginning of our relationship will hereby be celebrated in 2 days' time.
At Chesley's.
I will put it in my calendar.
Thank you.
you go anywhere by yourself.
Oh, Fincher, don't start. Whoever did this wasn't trying to kill me. They just wanted to scare me off.
Well, they succeeded in scaring me. Did Monty find anything on the knife?
No fingerprints. And it wasn't from the same set as the knife that killed Clayton Morrell. Monty is working on getting video surveillance. And I did not see the license plate.
What did you see?
I was blinded by the high beams. I saw a black SUV. That's it.
This whole thing has my stomach in knots.
What's going on over there?
Alex is moving into Paulina's office.
Well, he didn't waste any time.
Mm-hmm.
I can carry this one myself.
Where's Paulina's assistant?
Oh, Alex fired him.
Are you still friendly with maintenance?
Haley, I could lose my job.
I'm sorry. No, you're right. I forget I said anything.
But I don't know if I want to keep working at a place that's so quick to turn on one of its own. Gonna make a call here. Hey, it's Finch. Need a little favor. Thanks. I promise I'll lock up. Go ahead. Save me some. I can't believe I had to give up my cheesesteak for this. What are we looking for again?
That box that Alex wouldn't let anyone else hold. It had yellow tape. Look.
Ooh, there we go. Okay. You got it?
Jeez, it's a mess. It's not like Alex. He was always very tidy. These look like they're from different cases. These are important documents. This is a witness statement from a Thomas Floyd.
Thomas Floyd? This has been missing for weeks. Went missing before it was ever uploaded to the main server.
Here is a witness statement for an armed robbery.
The hard drive to mesh. This must be the full file on this armed robbery. This explains how it managed to disappear off the mainframe. Haley, these are the missing case files.
The ones that Paulina was being blamed for. Alex was hiding them from her. He was trying to get her fired.
When that didn't work.
He framed her for murder instead.
What are you doing in here? Get out.
We have to talk.
I'm calling security.
Oh, go ahead. I'd be happy to show them these.
What do you want?
The truth? You were sabotaging Paulina.
She sabotaged herself. Going to the prison after Clayton Morrell was released. Obsessively tracking his every move. Constantly asking me if there were any reports about him.
So instead of helping her with her issues, you thought you'd do this?
I misplaced a few files. It's hardly a crime.
Framing her for murder is.
What are you talking about?
Why was Derek Robinson here the day Clayton Morrell was killed?
It's none of your business.
You two plotting against Paulina?
No.
Alex, you're next in line. You have motive.
And an alibi. The night Clayton Morrell died, I was at a birthday dinner across town.
I've known you a really long time. Paulina's known you just as long. The Alex I came up through the ranks with would never keep information about a murder case secret, especially if an innocent woman could go to prison.
I don't know if Paulina did it or not, but Derek did come to see me. I said if I helped him bury a mistake from his past, he'd make sure Paulina's DEA days were over.
How? By planting the murder weapon in Paulina's car?
I didn't ask. I didn't want to know.
Alex is being fully investigated and is no longer acting DEA. At best, he'll be disbarred. At worst, he'll be disbarred and criminally charged for evidence tampering.
It's sad to see what ambition can do to someone. He wasn't always like this.
What about the charges against Paulina?
Well, they still stand, I'm afraid. The chief and the mayor are both very keen on getting this all wrapped up.
What about Derek Robinson?
Yeah, Paulina didn't stick the knife in Haley's tire, run her into a cement wall.
I know that, and the chief knows that too, but Paulina is still the prime suspect. And unfortunately, we've gotten a lead on the SUV. The security footage didn't get a clear view of the license plate, and the tinted out windows made it impossible to see the driver.
So we have no idea who was driving?
No. But I've got a car patrolling your street, Haley, just in case.
Thank you. I'm gonna see if Paulina has any insight into all of this.
Good idea. I'm gonna see if I can track down that violation that Alex mentioned.
Meet you at the food truck?
Yes. See you in a bit.
Alex? I don't know what to say.
I know it's a shock.
I brought him up through the ranks. He was my right-hand guy. I mean, how could he do something like this to me?
I guess his ambition overtook his loyalty.
I thought I was losing my mind. I just never would have imagined that Alex would do something like this.
I'm so sorry.
I feel like such a fool. I knew something was going on. But then Clayton Morrell got out of jail and I just couldn't see straight.
But you weren't letting things slip. You were still in control. At work, at least.
It's a small consolation, I guess.
You don't seem as surprised about Derek.
No. I actually wondered about Derek, but I didn't want to think he could be so cruel. Leading up to Clayton Morrell's trial, we were dating. It was getting serious, actually.
I had no idea.
No one did. I think I just wanted to be sure before it went public. But then Clayton Morrell wanted to hire him to defend him.
Had you ever come up across the bench from him before?
Sure. It's not unethical for opposing counsel to date as long as you disclose it to your client. But this wasn't about legal ethics.
It was about you.
I just couldn't deal with him defending a monster like Clayton Morrell. I didn't see a future with a man who would do anything to have a wife murderer set free.
You couldn't separate the personal from the professional?
Not on that case, no. I ended the relationship before the trial began. And I broke his heart. I don't think he ever forgave me.
Can you think of a mistake he made in the past that he would want to cover up?
No. But his career really went downhill after Clayton was convicted. He's a changed man. I wouldn't put anything past him.
Would he frame you for murder?
I honestly don't know. But if he killed his client, it wasn't just to get back at me.
So the good news is, Paulina has been granted bail and she'll be leaving today. She has to wear an ankle monitor, but it's better than jail.
I'll swing by from time to time to check on her to make sure she's all right. In the meantime, I found out that Clayton Morrell never paid Derek for his legal services.
That explains his reaction when Monty mentioned billing by the hour. Was he being blackmailed?
Maybe that's a violation that Derek wanted Alex to cover up for him.
If anyone would know, Naomi would.
Yeah, I tried to talk to her. It didn't happen.
There is one other person who knows just as much about Clayton Morrell as anyone.
My thoughts exactly.
I don't know exactly what Clayton had over Derek, but whatever it was, the threat of putting it in the book was enough to keep Derek on as his lawyer. I bet the publisher wouldn't even put it in the book.
Were there a lot of things that didn't go in the book?
They wanted Clayton to come off as sympathetic. So everything leading up to the trial and after it had to frame Clayton in the most human way.
I take it that isn't what you wanted to write.
It wasn't my choice. But Clayton wanted me to write the truth. He wanted everyone to know exactly what he'd done.
That must have been difficult for you, writing about the murder of one friend by another.
Why are you asking all of this?
We're just trying to get the whole picture.
You don't think the district attorney is guilty?
I work for the DA's office. With high-profile cases like this, we have to make sure all the avenues are explored before we can move forward.
Of course, yes. Well, the only thing Clayton told me was that he didn't think Derek was worth paying since he couldn't win a trial even by manufacturing evidence.
Manufacturing evidence? Could you say more about that?
You know I'm a lawyer, right? I don't have to say anything to you.
I noticed you didn't obtain your own representation.
Because I have nothing to hide.
Tell me about the Clayton Morrell case 10 years ago.
What about it?
We received information that Clayton Morrell was blackmailing you for free legal services. Is that true?
No.
Did you see how he blurted his answer out so quickly? That's a tactic.
Not a good one.
Then the reason for the blackmail was also false?
Obviously.
He's shaken now.
Did you go to Alex Mathers and promise him that you would get rid of Paulina D'Orazio if he would get rid of a mistake for you? Did you kill Clayton Morrell and frame Paulina D'Orazio?
No.
Not so obvious that time.
Well, it makes sense. Get rid of the blackmailer and the woman who broke your heart all in one fell swoop.
I swear I didn't kill anyone. Yes. Clayton was blackmailing me.
Because you manufactured evidence. When? During his trial?
Yes. I manufactured evidence in Clayton's trial. A man's shoe print out of the bathroom window. I was hoping to help Clayton's claim that someone had tried to break in.
It didn't work, obviously.
The judge threw it out because it wasn't processed through the police lab.
Because if it had been, the police would have realized it was a fake.
I made up the whole report. Staged photographs, everything. It was stupid, and I regret it. I just wanted to beat Paulina.
You call.
I'm texting Monty. I have a feeling.
Did you threaten Haley in the parking garage? I assume the truck doesn't belong to you. And I have a feeling that a quick check through your credit card statements would list a recent vehicle rental.
I knew that if she kept poking around, she'd find out about it eventually. I thought I could scare her off.
And what about the night Clayton Morrell was killed? Did you try to scare him off too?
I don't have an alibi, but I didn't kill him, and I didn't frame Paulina.
And how were you proposing to get rid of her for DA Mathers?
I was going to take the stand during her trial and testify about our relationship. I was going to say that Paulina used me for information that allowed her to win the original case that sent Clayton to prison.
And was that true?
It could have been.
Perjury is a crime.
Yeah, but it isn't murder. And you can't arrest me for something that I might have said in the future. Clayton's death doesn't solve my problem. Naomi knows everything, so I'm still stuck representing her pro bono. You want a real suspect? Dig into her deeper. What you'll find will surprise you.
So Haley, how did you know Derek was the one that threatened you?
I didn't, not for sure, but it didn't make sense to me that the real killer would risk proving they were still out there.
So Derek's motive for scaring you off was to keep his secret under wraps. So now I guess we believe that Derek wasn't the one that planted the knife in Paulina's car.
And we're still looking for the person who did.
When we originally looked into Naomi Morrell, we didn't look outside of Georgia. So I ran her fingerprints through APHIS.
You found something.
Naomi Morrell's real name is Melody Gorinsky. She lived in Seattle, moved here 6 years ago, changed her name, and started visiting Clayton Morrell in prison.
Why'd she change her name?
A year after Clayton Morrell was convicted for the murder of his wife, Naomi, or Melody, as she was then called, was arrested for the attempted murder of her husband.
I did not see that one coming.
So what exactly happened?
Well, not much, according to Seattle police. Her husband found detailed plans outlining how she would do it. She was arrested, charged, and found not guilty.
That was a lenient judge.
Well, she claimed it was an elaborate prank.
I bet the husband disagreed.
They divorced, and the rest we know.
So when did she start corresponding with Clayton?
Right after he was convicted. Police found letters from him encouraging her to free herself of her husband and come be with him instead. Seattle police believed that he was influencing her to do it.
I don't know about that. Naomi exhibits many of the same traits as Clayton. Lack of empathy is a key indicator of sociopathic tendencies.
She planned on killing one husband but didn't go through with it.
Maybe second husband's a child.
Maybe.
I'm not saying anything until my lawyer gets here.
Oh, didn't he tell you?
We know all about the evidence he manufactured in your husband's trial, and he will no longer be representing you.
So let's pick up where we left off last time, Naomi. Or should I call you Melody?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Naomi, this is going...
I don't know what you're talking about.
Naomi, this is going to go much better for you if you're honest. I know all about your first husband and your plans to kill him. Why didn't you go through with it?
It was just a prank.
But then your second husband ends up dead and you have no alibi.
You can see why I would find that coincidence hard to believe.
It is a coincidence. I didn't kill Clayton.
Why did you lie about where you were that day?
I lied because I knew you'd try to pin this on me.
Why did you come back to Atlanta last Friday? You can tell me or you can go to jail.
Fine. I came for a meeting about a reality show.
I don't follow.
A producer wants to make a reality show about me and my life as a wife of a murderer.
Oh, and was your husband okay with this?
Hardly. It's why Clayton and I fought. He refused to let me do it. He was the star in our family. He didn't want any competition.
Well, I can see why you'd be angry.
I told him I was going away for a few days. I drove back, had a meeting with the producer. They took me out for dinner.
Why didn't you just tell me this?
They made me sign an NDA. They didn't want anyone copying their idea before the network greenlit it. Now I'm gonna get sued.
I confirmed Naomi's alibi. The story about the reality show is true. Can't believe anyone would want to watch that.
It's not something I'd watch, but I've seen the fascination.
I bet the producers weren't too happy that the cops came calling.
On the contrary, they were ecstatic. They asked if I would be willing to post for publicity shots of Naomi being arrested.
Oh. That's... I don't even know what that is.
This means that Naomi is no longer a viable suspect.
Paulina's still on the hook.
Yeah, I'm afraid so. And the only outstanding piece of evidence that we haven't been able to tie her to is the shoe print. We've done a full search of Paulina's home, office, and everywhere in between. But nothing.
Then there's still hope.
And that's what I admire about you, Haley. You always find a glimmer of hope.
I'll look for the shoe, but if the cops haven't found it yet, I don't know what I'll be able to do.
And it may never be found, which at least means it cannot be linked to Paulina.
Do you ever think that Paulina's guilty?
Honestly, no. Why, have you?
I have to admit, I've had my moments.
There's a lot of evidence piled against her, I get it.
Yeah, but you've never wavered, not once, not even when everybody else is.
As much as Paulina may have thought about murder, I know her. And she would never break the law, no matter how much she thinks it had failed her.
I know that you'll always believe in me the same way.
Pincher, please don't tell me that you're about to be arrested for a crime you didn't commit.
Yeah, not that I know of. But if I was, I know you'd be there to, you know, prove me innocent.
Assuming you were innocent.
You think I have it in me to be a criminal?
Under the right circumstances.
Like what?
Like, okay, say that all the burritos in Atlanta were locked up in a high security vault.
So last time it was the food truck, now?
Just burritos this time.
Burritos, okay. And you think that I'd be the first person to break in? You'd be absolutely right. Desperate times calls for desperate burrito burglaries. I'd be a hero.
Mm-hmm.
Modern day Robin Hood, protecting Atlanta from a burrito-less future.
Why do I get the feeling that we're gonna make a detour on the way to my office?
You know me too well, girl. You got me thinking about burritos all day.
That's all you ever think about. Oh, hey.
Yo.
I know how we can get there fast.
Hi, do you have a minute?
For you, always.
Amelia didn't show, and she's not answering her phone or responding to my texts.
And she didn't call to cancel?
No, and I'd go make sure she's okay, but I have a client due any minute.
Well, why don't I run by your school right now?
Thank you. I'm sorry to drag you into this again. I'm just worried.
Me too.
Hi. Look at this.
Well, thanks to Miss Lincoln. She organized the whole thing. It's a great way to teach our students about sustainability, and all the proceeds are going to charity.
That's a great idea. Miss Lincoln's actually who I'm looking for.
Oh, I'm afraid she isn't here.
Is she all right? I'm Haley Dean. I'm a friend of hers.
Honestly, I don't know. I haven't been able to reach her. She's been planning this clothing drive for months. I can't believe she's missing it.
Put those over by the shoes?
Shoes.
A last-minute addition to the drive. Miss Lincoln thought we might as well sell full outfits.
She was a match to the bloody print that we found at the scene of Clayton Morrell's murder. It's got Amelia's DNA all over it. This is her shoe. I sent a car out to her apartment. She isn't there.
I tried calling her. No answer. I don't understand. She was at parent-teacher night.
She was. I called everyone on the schedule. One parent didn't show up, and Amelia didn't mark it in the record that she submitted to the office.
Do you think she could have gotten from the school to the Morrell house and back?
I checked her car's GPS.
And it verified the route.
It did. I have an APB out for Amelia. In the meantime, I need to go see the chief. This is good news, Haley. She was exactly what we need to exonerate Paulina.
I can't tell you how happy I am to be out of that holding cell.
It must have been so scary.
I'm just glad I'm home. Though showering with this ankle bracelet on is interesting.
It shouldn't be much longer, as soon as they find Amelia.
Oh, it breaks my heart, Haley. I can't help but feel responsible.
I can understand that feeling, but you know none of this is your fault.
Intellectually, yes. But if I had just gone for murder in the first degree and not manslaughter 10 years ago, Clayton Morrell would still be in jail and none of this would have happened.
But tomorrow would still be dead and Amelia would still be angry.
but to be pushed to that extreme. So what's next?
Monty is working on getting the charges against you dropped, but it'll take some time.
I can handle that, as long as I know this nightmare is almost over.
It was no problem to see you last minute. I'm just glad you called. You're still here. Last minute crisis. She is supposed to get married this weekend, and thankfully she called me before she called it off.
And you're heading straight to the wedding?
Oh, no. I have a date with Jonas, the anniversary of our first date.
Oh, how exciting. Well, you need a lift?
No, I'm going to transcribe my notes while they're still fresh.
Well, have fun. And after everything that's happened lately, you deserve it. And I deserve to live vicariously through you.
Sabrina? Hello?
Haley.
Amelia.
I think I need your help.
Jonas, I feel terrible, but she came to me for help, so I don't feel like I can leave.
That's no big deal. Anniversaries are just a number on a calendar.
But you wanted to have a special night.
Haley, every night I get to spend with you is a special night.
I'm so lucky.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Bye.
You want to come in with me on this one, Haley? I think my odds of getting the truth will be better with someone she trusts in the room.
Anything I can do to help.
Thank you. Amelia, why didn't you tell us what happened the night that Clayton Morrell was killed?
Take your time, Amelia.
You remember I told you about my sister's vase? I knew Clayton was never going to give it back. I mean, he went to the trouble of filing a complaint against me to the police. I knew I was going to have to steal it.
And parent-teacher night was the best cover story.
I didn't plan it, really. One of the parents couldn't make it at the last minute. I had a 45-minute window. I called Clayton's house. No one answered. I thought I would drive by and see if he was home.
And what about the shoes?
I don't like to drive in heels, so I always change into sneakers when I get into the car.
So you drove to his house?
All the lights were off. I snuck up to the window and took a look inside.
How'd you get in?
My sister's spare key. I walked in, straight into the living room. I stepped in something sticky, so I stopped. And
keep going.
There was Clayton. Dead. Blood everywhere.
And you're certain that Clayton Morrell was dead when you arrived?
I've never been more certain. I ran back to my car and back to the school.
And added your shoes to the donation pile.
Why didn't you tell anyone? Were you afraid you'd be arrested?
It sounds crazy. But I was happy, so happy, that I didn't want whoever killed him to get caught. Keeping the secret seemed like a way of saying thank you for avenging my sister. And giving Clayton the death he deserved.
So you don't think Amelia's the killer?
I never really did. I believe her. I believe Amelia's story. I have never known her to hold back on her feelings, and she wears her heart on her sleeve.
So you don't think she can lie?
It's not that I don't think she can lie, more that I'm convinced she's telling the truth.
So what does that do for the case?
Well, Paulina's still on the hook for Clayton Morrell's murder. I don't know where to go next.
Have you ever considered that maybe Paulina did it?
No.
Not even for a moment?
No.
Don't you think maybe you should?
Fincher, if I were arrested for murder, would you think for a moment that I did it?
No.
Exactly.
Would you think I did it?
In a heartbeat.
Maybe you're right.
Amelia is being charged with tampering with the crime scene and failing to report a crime. But that's it.
I expected that.
Which means, of course, Paulina is still the prime suspect. And the mayor wants action. I have to turn the file over to the DA's office. I don't know who'll be handling it, but I can't stall anymore.
I know.
So that's it, then.
You know you don't have to pretend with me.
Honestly, Haley, I'm terrified.
I would be worried if you weren't.
But I can't have spent my whole life upholding the law to give up on it now. I'm innocent, and I won't rest until I prove it.
Did you see Pauline on the news? When she said she wouldn't rest until she proved her innocence, no matter the cost, I believed her.
I hope the real killer was watching.
Hey, if I was them, I'd be worried.
So he never told me what happened with Megan.
What happened?
You know, the jewelry, the roses, ring any bells?
Right, right. Well, it just hasn't happened yet.
What are you waiting for?
The right moment, I guess.
Fincher, you know that I know that you're not telling me the whole story here.
Sorry, Haley, it's not my story to tell.
All right, whatever's going on with you and Megan, I hope it all works out.
Me too. But you be the first to know. This has been fun, but I gotta get to a stakeout. DA's office is in a total uproar. Now that Alex is out, everyone's jockeying to replace him. I'm gonna avoid that place as much as possible.
Smart tactic. I don't miss those power games.
I'm gonna walk you to your car.
That's very sweet, but I'm gonna go to the bookstore. I need a distraction, so I'll see you tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Breakfast on you.
Paulina D'Orazio, leave a message.
Paulina, it's Haley. I was just going by a bookstore and wondered if... Oh, that's my other line. I'll call you back. Hey, Monty, what's up?
Haley, have you talked to Paulina lately?
I saw her this afternoon about 1 o'clock.
Has she been in contact with you since?
No. I just tried calling her, but there was no answer. What's going on?
A patrol car drove by her house on routine check and found her ankle monitor cut off.
She took off her ankle monitor?
When you saw her...
Did she say anything about where she might go?
There's no way she's running.
What other explanation is there?
Just, let me know if she calls you.
Will do.
Fincher,
it's me. Meet me at Clayton Morrell's house right away. He's unconscious but still breathing. 11527 Wood Avenue.
It wasn't me, it is now.
You read true crime. You know what killers are like, what they do. I don't see that in you.
Maybe you just don't know me.
I get it. I would do anything for my friends, too. Paulina, are you okay?
Haley, what are you doing here?
Stop talking. I need to think.
Frank, let her go.
No, let Haley go. I don't know what you want with me, but it's got nothing to do with Haley.
I said shut up!
What about Tamara? The woman you loved, Clayton Morrell murdered. It must have been so hard for you to write that book and have to talk about her murder again and again and again.
Clayton lied to me for years. And then he wanted the book to be full of truth. How he planned it. How he enjoyed it, how it made him feel powerful. Tamara didn't deserve that. She deserved...
You? Tamara glowed with a lightness of spirit that felt like a balm to my darkness. That's how a man in love writes about a woman.
Clayton laughed at me when I wrote that. He wasn't laughing when I stabbed him.
You killed him to avenge Tamara?
I couldn't take it. Clayton out there, Clayton free, and the book out there. I didn't know what to do, Haley.
But you knew enough about crime to know that you had to have a plan. You needed to get rid of your witnesses, and that's why you sent Walter on a fishing trip.
You knew.
I saw the gone fishing sign in your window. Walter had the same one. And then you needed a fall guy, and that was Paulina.
Yeah. You sent me the note. You lured me to the parking lot that was close enough to the house to make it plausible. And you planted the knife in my car?
In your own driveway.
It was a good plan, Frank. The thing I don't understand, you were getting away with it. Why would you kidnap her?
No. No, don't you see? It was because of her. That Clayton was only in jail for 10 years. He should have been there for life. She doesn't deserve to tell her truth, Haley. She doesn't deserve her day in court. That is injustice. You're not gonna stop me.
So what do you need next?
I need to make it look like Paulina here can't stand the guilt. And what better place to have her commit suicide than the house where this whole nightmare started? That's the ultimate poetic justice.
You really thought this through, except for the part about me.
I know. Dad, I don't want to kill you, Haley.
Then don't.
I've killed one with two more.
Two more makes you a serial killer. Two more makes you worse than Clayton Morrell.
I just don't know what to do.
Haley, you got him?
Yeah.
Haley!
You're looking well.
I feel well, better than I have in a long time. How's Walter Faraday?
He'll make a full recovery.
Oh, I'm so relieved to hear it. I owe him a visit.
What about Frank?
I have been assured that he is going to plead guilty.
I think that's a wise move.
Have you talked to Amelia?
She's back in therapy, and she will be just fine. Oh, she wanted to thank us for making good use of her family base. How about you?
I don't think I realized how wrapped up I've been in the past. I'm really looking forward to starting my own practice. I could use the change of pace.
Oh, so you're gonna slow down?
Why not? You did.
That's true. You need some help?
Not anymore. I'm good now.
So, all's well that ends well.
Got a little scary there for a bit, I'll admit it.
So you and Jonas finally have your big date.
Why are you so interested in my love life?
I just want you to be happy.
Sure you do.
You sound like you don't believe me.
What's been going on the last few days?
I told you it's not my story to tell.
It's our anniversary, or I should say, all of our anniversaries. This is the wine we had the first night we met. These are the cheesesteaks we ate the next night we got together.
And that's the lipstick you wore the first time we kissed. Haley, this is incredible.
Fincher was right, it's the perfect date.
Fincher, is that why he was asking me all those weird questions?
I asked him to keep it a secret. I wanted to create the perfect night, but looks like I didn't need to.
I just felt so bad about missing all of our anniversaries. So I thought, you know what? Let's just have a new one.
That's exactly what I was hoping to do. Haley Dean, I have loved you since the very first moment I met you. Will you marry me?